Well, Boats on Land is essentially a collection of short stories, 15 stories in all, and they're set in and around Shillong, so in parts of Meghalaya, Cherrapunji, and pockets of Assam, and they're essentially places where I grew up and spent a certain amount of time when I was a child. And they basically weave folklore into sort of a larger background of historical events, and they form a sort of reimagining of these places over a century and a half. The first story starts in the 1850s and the last story ends in contemporary, sort of our contemporary time. So yeah, so they act almost like a historical, sociological reimagining of this place and its people.
Okay.
I think that's a really difficult question to answer. It depends. It depends on my mood. Sometimes I'm really frivolous. Sometimes it's the title story, Boats on Land. And sometimes it's at Kutmadan because I love Cherrapunji.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's beautiful and atmospheric. Sometimes it's a story called The Dream of the Golden Machine, which is about water fairies. So it keeps changing. I think it's... I'm a very restless writer. I walk a lot while writing because I try and get the rhythm of my sentences perfect.
Mm-hmm.
So I write, I mean, I walk and I look out of windows, and I can write early morning, late at night, it doesn't really matter. I think I have a rather erratic pattern.
Oh.
I think writing is quite possibly one of the most difficult things to do in the world, because you are not just writing, you're also being self-critical, you're editing your own work, you're trying to imagine other people, other characters, other places, and you're trying to make it seem effortless. It is bloody difficult. Well, what motivates me? Well, I think that I've always been writing. I don't remember a time when I wasn't writing. So I think the motivation is to just reimagine the world in as unique a way as I possibly can, which is entirely mine. How do I shape a story? I think it depends. Some stories fall into my hands and they are perfectly polished and they're set and I just need to put them down on paper. And some stories I feel like I'm in one of those blacksmith workshops. I am battering it out with a hammer. Not until just now. I think you just do the best you can do without really trying to make it more difficult than it already is. I'm really glad if it inspires people to write and to tell their own stories. I think it's fantastic. I think the pressure, the most amount of pressure, comes from within.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Favorite books,
mm-hmm.
off the top of my head,
mm-hmm.
1984, George Orwell,
mm-hmm.
The Great Gatsby, Fitzgerald, Mrs. Dalloway, Virginia Woolf, Dhruva Hazarika's Bowstring Winter, which is set in Shillong,
mm-hmm.
it's beautiful. Favorite magazines, I would have to say The New Yorker, which has served as a really great inspiration for my own short stories. They're beautiful, they're entirely a genre of their own. Well, I think the only thing I can say is when you're sitting in front of a page and you're writing, just be very self-critical. It's really important because everybody can write, but I think it takes a lot of self-discipline to be a really, really good writer. Well, to write a novella. I'm quite fascinated by the form. It's beautiful. It's like sculpture almost, because you chisel away all the things that you don't need and you're left with something entirely sculpted and intact. A lot of the books I've been reading are novellas, and there's a difference between a short story and a novel. They're sort of precariously balanced in between. So I'd like to write one next.